Hi everyone, my name is Mitesh and welcome to this tutorial on building a customized Q&A chatbot application that can be deployed locally on your desktop, laptop using open source tools and framework. As part of this tutorial, we will walk you through the steps of how you can create an assistant, a copilot, that can answer questions based on your proprietary data. Again, the goal is to showcase how you can create a chatbot application that can be deployed locally on devices that has got smaller GPU footprint. So let's dive in. So this is what a high-level workflow would look like. We are using RAG, or Retrieval Augmented Generation-based workflow that provides the ability to connect these LLM models to your proprietary data source. As you can see in this slide, the high-level workflow consists of different components that are integrated together. The overall workflow can be divided into two steps. The first step is to convert your enterprise data, which can be in the form of PDF, text, manuals, into vector embeddings and store it in a vector database. You can think of this as a one-time offline step. If you need to add more, the second step is when you are running your application in real time. In this, the prompt from the user is used to do a semantic search in the vector database to find the relevant documents to the query. These documents, along with the prompt, are passed to the foundation model, which in turn formulates a response for the user. Now that we know what the high level looks like, let's double click on the first step. In order to convert your data into embeddings and store it in a vector database, we need two things: an embedding model and defining a vector database. Apart from this, one also needs to take care of other parameters such as chunk size and overlap. Chunk size parameter helps in dividing the documents into groups, whereas the overlap parameter is used to define the overlap between these chunks. From an embedding model standpoint, one also needs to think about which embedding model to use. The selection of both embedding models and other parameters such as chunk size and overlap will heavily depend on the memory of your GPU. Lastly, all these components, the embedding model, vector database, are tied together with an orchestration framework. As I said before, this is a one-time offline process. So now that we have our vector database set up, the next step is integration of the real-time user query component with the vector database. In this step, the user queries are used to find the closest semantic match in the vector database. The selected results from the vector database are passed to the LLM model along with the query, which is used to generate a response for the user query. Now that we know the workflow and how different components are tied together, the next step is to decide which tools and frameworks should we use. There are many open source and enterprise tools out there that one can use to build these applications. For example, for orchestration, we have LangChain, Llama Index, Dipset, Glen, and various others. Similarly, for vector database, we have FAISS, Milvus, OpenSearch, Redis. For foundation models, we can use models hosted by different services such as Hugging Face, NVIDIA, and OLLAMA. For the user interface, there are a few frameworks such as Gradio and Streamlit that one can capitalize on. Again, these are just a few frameworks that I have listed here, but there are many other tools and frameworks that are out there that one can leverage. Okay, so now that we know about different frameworks that are out there, for this application, we will be using LangChain as our main orchestration framework, which has got plugins for various models in vector databases. We will be showcasing how to use embedding models hosted on Hugging Face. We will show you how they can download locally and how you can use them to create embeddings for your proprietary documents. We will also be showcasing how those vector embeddings be stored using FAISS vector database, which is GPU accelerated. Lastly, for the foundation model, we will be using an optimized version of Llama 3 instruct model hosted using NIMs or NVIDIA inference microservice. Lastly, for user interaction, we will be using Gradio for this application. So now that we know all the components that we're going to use, let's dive into the coding piece. Okay, so the first step is to create a vector database using your proprietary data set. So we will be installing a whole bunch of dependencies to get started on that. As mentioned before, we are using the LangChain orchestration framework. Hence, we need those libraries. We will be using Hugging Face or embedding model hosted on Hugging Face. So we need the Hugging Face plugin as well. We need PyPDF to parse through PDF data. We are using FAISS vector database to store our vector embeddings, and we will need the LangChain NVIDIA AI endpoint library, as we'll be using the Llama 3 instruct model hosted through NVIDIA NIMs. All right, so let's run that. I have already installed all these dependencies, so I'll get most of them already exist. Okay, so now we have all the dependencies installed. Let's import the libraries that we need. We will be using the document loader from LangChain as well as the text splitter. This is where this function will help us splitting the documents into different sizes or chunks. We need the Hugging Face plugin with LangChain because we will be using the embedding model hosted on Hugging Face, and we need the plugin for the vector database. Let's run that. Okay. All right, so now that we have all our imports, the next step is to provide the path to the embedding model. We will be using the embedding model hosted on Hugging Face. For this notebook, we are using the SFR embedding Mistral model, which was 5th or 6th on the MTEB leaderboard at the time of this recording. We also need to provide the path to where the documents are located, and we need to provide the name with which we'll be saving the vector database. So let's run this. So the next step is we'll initialize few global variables, the vector store and the embeddings. As this is an example notebook, we are initializing few global variables, but if you are trying to use the same notebook in a production environment, I'm sure all these variables will be part of a class. But for ease of usage here, or more explainability of the code, we are just going to define them as global variables. All right, so the next step is to write the function to download the embedding model from Hugging Face. So we are checking for whether we have a GPU on our desktop or laptop. We are providing a bunch of arguments for the encoders as well as the model. And then we are passing those arguments to the Hugging Face plugin to download the embeddings. And the embeddings will be stored in the variable embeddings. All right, let's run both these functions. Okay, that's good to go. That's good to go as well. All right, so now that we have downloaded the embedding model, the next step is to process PDF. Here we are loading the PDF using the PyPDF function, and we are splitting each of those PDF pages into different chunk sizes. The two variables that we can control here is the size of splitting the document, which is the chunk size, how many tokens we want to split the documents into, and the chunk overlap. What should be the overlap between the previous chunk and the current chunk when we are trying to divide that document? So that is what this function will do. Again, it will process one PDF at a time, and those PDFs are divided, loaded as pages, and using those pages, the split function happens. All right, and let's run this function as well. All right, so we have the two most important functions that we need. The next step is to put both of them together. So here is where we provide the path to where the documents are located, and then we process each of those PDF files, divide them into different chunk sizes based on the process PDF function that we had defined. We download the embedding model by calling the function, and then we pass all the chunks that we have created with the embedding model and create the FAISS vector database. Once we have that, we will save the vector database so that we can use it for future purposes or when we run this whole application in real time. All right, let's run this function. All right, so we have all the important functions defined. Let's run them and generate embeddings for PDF documents that are located in the PDF directory. So let's run this function. So there you see it is downloading the embedding model. It has divided the two PDF documents that we have in the sample data set into 212 chunks. This will take a while because the model, I think it's 26 GB. So I'll let it download and I'll come back once the whole process is done. A few important things that one should note while you are doing this is when you decide which embedding model to use, that will heavily depend on the memory that your GPU has. Also, another parameter that you need to keep in mind is the chunk size. What is the token size that you want to divide your document into? Because that will heavily rely on your GPU size as well, or the memory in your memory of your GPU as well. So these are a few things that you need to take into consideration when you're designing your application. For this notebook, I am using an A6000 GPU. So that has a memory of 48 GB. But if I had a 3090 or a 4090 GPU, I'll pick my models accordingly because the memory sizes changes drastically. So I'll wait for this process to run and we'll come back after this processing is done. All right, so there you have it. We downloaded the embedding model. We divided the two PDF files that we have in the sample data set into chunk sizes of 212. And then each of those chunks were processed and generated embeddings out of that and saved into the FAISS vector database. The printout message is not that clear. I will change it when we publish this notebook for people to use it. So before we move to the second part of this application, which is the online piece where the user can query, interact with the vector database through queries and generate a response for that, it is always a good idea to test whether the embeddings that we have generated are doing the right things or not. So let's write a few quick functions to test the vector database and the embeddings that it is generating. So here's the load vector database function. All this function is doing is it is loading the FAISS vector database, and then we are moving it to the GPU memory. So that is all this function is doing. Let's run it. And the next step is to define the test VDB function. In this function, we are calling the vector database as retriever, and then we are asking a simple question: what is DORA? Now I know when we created the vector database, one of the papers that we used was the DORA paper. So if I ask a question, what is DORA, it should give me the correct response. So let's run this. All right, so let's run both the functions, load vector database, which will load it, and then test the vector database. And let's see what comes out. So there you are. So we are retrieving four documents. As I said, you want to know what is DORA. That was the question, which is one of the papers that we are generating vector embeddings out of. So DORA, weighted decomposed low ranking adaptation, text to image generation, figure 10, figure 9. We are only printing the first 100 characters, and hence we don't have the whole text. But I am presuming if we print more than 100 characters, we should have the right text. So give or take, it is doing the right thing. So that's good. Now let's go to the next piece where we code up the second piece, which is the user interaction part, where the user can enter the query and retrieve the relevant documents from the vector database and create a response for us. So let's do that. All right, so now that we have created the vector database, the next step is to code up the online piece, which is the user can interact with both the vector database and the foundation model to get responses to their queries accordingly. So let's do that. So before we get started on the online piece, the first step you need to take is download and deploy the NIM container locally. So if you go to build.nvidia.com, you can search for Llama 3. You should get the NIM container. And if you go onto the Docker tab, you should be able to follow the steps and deploy the container locally so that you can interact with it. You will have to create your login credentials and generate your API key, which you will need to deploy the model locally. Another important thing to note is, say for example, your GPU does not have sufficient memory, then you can always deploy it on-prem on GPUs that has got that much amount of memory. And then come time interacting with that model, you can provide the right URL, which includes the IP address and the remainder of the URL. You can provide that and you can interact with that model no matter where it is deployed, locally or on an on-prem data center, which is private. So the next step would be to create a prompt template function. And what this function basically does is it provides a template of taking the context that is retrieved from the vector database and the question from the user, which is fed to the foundation model to create a response for the user. All right, let's run this function. So now that we have created the prompt template function, the next step is to create the chat response function. And this function will be called through Gradio. This is one of the most complex functions, so let's break it down into pieces because a lot of things are happening here. So the first thing I'm doing is I'm creating an instance for the LLM model that I will be talking to. In this case, we are using the Llama 3 8B instruct model that is deployed locally, and hence the URL is localhost 8000.
As I mentioned before, if you are interacting with a model that is deployed locally on-prem on your local data center, then you can use the URL accordingly. The next thing I'll need is the prompt template. So I'm creating an object for that as well. And both the LLM and the prompt template are passed to the create function, which creates a document chain. I am also creating a retriever object, which talks to the vector store. And all these three things are passed, the three things, the retriever, the LLM, and the prompt objects are passed to the retrieval chain. And this is the main object that will interact with user queries to create response accordingly. And what we are returning is the history of our interaction along with the response for the current question. So let's run this function. All right, so now we have all the functions that we need for our chat application. The next step is, of course, to wrap it with Gradio. So here we have the title of our application. We are providing path to where our documents are so that we can create a vector database. Again, this is an offline process, but we are providing all those, exposing all those functionalities through the UI or the application. Once you have that offline process done, which is these steps, then you can use, then we are integrating the chat response function, which we just coded in the previous block, where we are interacting with the vector database using our queries and the foundation model to get the right response. So yeah, we put that together and let's run it. All right, so after some debugging, I realized that somehow I restarted the notebook before coding up the online piece or the interaction piece. And that's the reason why the load function, load document function was throwing up an error. So now I restarted the whole notebook and ran all the cells together and it's doing just fine. So I think we are in good shape. Okay, so let's put the Gradio app together. We load the embedding model, the vector database, and then launch the app. So let's do all those things and see how things pan out. All right, there you go. We have our application up and running. So let's use the URL and see how it's doing. All right, so let's test the application. I restarted the whole notebook so that everything is cleaned up. Let's load the files. So here we are going to upload the two sample PDF files that we had, and we're going to create a vector embeddings out of that or a vector database out of it. So by clicking this, the load document function gets activated and it's going to create a vector database. All right. So we have vector embeddings for both the documents, and let's enter our question. What is the Yep, there we have it. Let's try some more question. How is it better than Laura? Okay, so yeah, there we have a chatbot application that is deployed locally. Everything, the documents are local, the vector database is local, as well as the model, the foundation model that we are using to interact is also deployed locally.